Thanator Den? Well, a remote location, no pollution whatsoever. Of course it had to be potentially occupied by some dangerous wildlife.
Found one. Looks quite ripe and healthy.
Excellent. Look for more, please. The more samples, the better.
Why can't I focus? Alex, something's wrong out here.
What do you mean?
Feels like someone's watching me.
I don't like this. Think you better get out of there. I mean it.
And I've sent you there without a heads up. Stupid. Almost got you killed.
And I've only got a few samples for you. Wish I could have gathered more.
Don't worry. If the samples are good enough, the data from them will still be sufficient. And now that we know that this is a dangerous territory, this knowledge will save lives. You know, people died exploring and studying Pandora. Some of them I knew very well, and they could have done so much more. I need to do better when considering the risks. People trust me when I send them out there. I must prove it's worth it. The samples you've collected will contribute into that. You were right about Talon. I'm glad I listened.
Children deserve to know what is behind that noise. Also, I deserve to return to Home Tree without the endless questions. Ah, the Sarentu. Perfect. Now, I am no coward, but there is a strange sound that wafts from the hills at night. Small concern given everything we are facing, right? Oh, the children disagree, though. Whenever I return to Home Tree, they say, "You always know what is happening, Leitao. Why can you not tell us what that sound is?" Their curiosity is so charming. And tiresome.
What do you think it is?
Likely someone with too much free time on their hands? The children think it may be the sky people in the hills nearby. But Nilnyan, he forbids us from looking into it. The lecture he gave us on danger was so stern and lengthy, my yawns could have shaken Home Tree loose from its soil.
Danger doesn't sound like something that would stop you.
Nilnyan lives a tedious life. He would not recognize actual danger if it walked right up to him and ate his dinner. He is an elder, though. When an elder speaks, we obey, for better or worse. So, if I tell the children what I find, I am also telling them I have gone against an elder's wishes. But you, child, are not a Ranahe, which means you can help me get the children off my back, as much as I love their endless pestering.
RDA gear. Late Thal was right. That sound. A quick fix might stop it.
They said that there was a pot of gold at the end of this rainbow. More like a pot of crap. Nothing here but danger and risk of death. And then there's that creepy noise I heard last night. Doesn't sound like anything I've ever heard. I'd be more scared if I wasn't so pissed off about losing sleep. The second I see an opening, I'm hightailing it out of here.
The sound was caused by a Sky People device. Looks like they dropped it. No Sky People around. Don't worry.
Well, well. One less Sky People contraption is a good thing. I will let the children know.
Gather with this pollution everywhere. Priya might know what to do. Hey, Priya?
What's up? Oh, crap.
What?
I spilled my coffee. I mean, calling it coffee is generous, but anyway.
Yeah. So I've reached a patch of forest that's heavily polluted. It's stopping me from getting the nectar I need.
Let me see. Yep, there's a facility near you. You'll have to take it out. That'll stop the pollution and the forest should clear up. Sid will help you do it quietly.
Okay. I'll go check it out.
Dropping the coordinates now. Remember, that place will be heavily guarded, so prepare before you go.
Another gas extraction facility.
Okay,
You got it.
These things don't rust, right?
Remind you, what we're fixing is an attack on return to control to ensure minimal damage.
didn't I just stay home?
Would you shut up?
Plan is watching me, I swear.
Well, that's not. I do not care.
Readings indicate a mechanical malfunction. Does anyone have eyes on it?
You need any of that.
It's not moving.
Oh. Odd.
was too easy killing blues today. Forest is healing. Should find that nectar now. Don't worry. That's better, isn't it? Got it. What kind of weird?
Well, I was doing some maintenance. That filtration system has me on edge. And also, have you ever noticed actually that with it?
Priya, the weird thing.
Oh, yeah, sorry. So I was straining to reach a part I needed, but then Nora comes over and he's like, let me get that for you. And hands me the thing.
What did you say?
Nothing. It just kind of froze and smiled. Anyway, he's been really helpful lately. Even to humans.
Maybe he's just getting used to you. I mean, you're not so bad.
Yeah, you're right. I'm glad, though. Anyway, I'd better go. Call if you need anything.
Don't worry. Let's hope this works.
Hope is the only thing we have left, my Aldu. Did you bring the nectar?
Ewa has brought us calm.
There will not be calm if Katna discovers our plan.
Is it going to hurt?
No! No.
Ewa, we enter your welcoming arms, at one with all things connected through you. Guide this traveler. Bring them to the heart of the nest.
She wants to gather the Kinglor. They are hungry. The queen guides them to flowers to feed. Wait, on the horizon. She sees an RDA facility, but she doesn't know what it is. To find more flowers for the Kinglor to feed. The energy pulses disturb her. She feels it. The swarm is agitated. It's confusing, so she keeps flying. There's something, an energy wave. It feels harsh. And the queen, she needs to find the other Kinglor. Protect them. A wave of energy. It's clothing the flowers that they feed on. The Kinglor are hungry, distressed. The balloons, the pulse is coming from the balloons. It pushes the Kinglor back. Discomfort confusion. She doesn't know how to get them away. Sees the shadow above, threatening the swarm. She's showing me that there are more balloons. That RDA facility. It's sending a signal to the balloons. The King Margro weak. The Queen must hurry. Find a safe place before the swarm dies.
And I think they're okay.
Eat this. You have been on a long journey.
What did the King or Queen show you?
I saw the Sky People's facility, looming over the forest. It's sending out a signal to the devices in the sky. That signal closes the flowers, stopping the King or from feeding. This forced them to the shelter of Home Tree. The devices can only be reached by air.
I'll shoot the floating devices down, every last one.
That won't be enough. The signal is coming from a Sky People base at the Stone Pillars. But I think I know how we can disable the sensors on the floating devices.
Then you must fly with us, but you'll need an IKRAN.
An IKRAN is an honor only Katnat can grant. And he will not.
The King Lore has shown the Sky People to be the source of their troubles. He has to listen this time. I'll gather the hunters. Their bows will be ready to help save the King Lore. Nafika will meet you at the base of the Rukri.
It is time for you to soar, Mayaundu. I will bring Itu. It will comfort him to see you make the bond.
We'll meet at a high place near the Rukri. Let our arrows fly true when we descend on the Sky People.
What if I don't make a bond?
You shall still have honor, Mayaundu. They shall sing songs of how an IKRAN tossed you from the rookery. First, you must connect to Ewa. She will prepare you for the IKRAN bond. Let us not stand around waiting to be caught out.
Through here? Is it safe?
I am not sending you to your doom. Go on. Trust me, Mayantu.
That's what you said about the Kinglor sting.
Here. I use this with Zormi. May you find a bond as strong as ours.
Oh, and Mayantu. Our hunters always say, do not look down. I suggest you heed their wisdom.
What took you so long? I slowed down for you.
How did you get up here so fast?
Ha! I spent my childhood climbing these mountains. I know all their tricks.
You're feeling better then?
In body, not yet in spirit. She looks a little skittish. It is up to her if she chooses you.
Hey, did I meet you before?
Do not worry. No self-respecting IKRAN would accept the first attempt. Continue your climb. Show her you are worthy.
I hope so. Hey, Priya. You will never guess where I am right now.
The Irana agents blew you in one of their dive ads, did they?
The opposite. I'm climbing the IKRAN rookery. To be chosen. At least, I hope I get chosen.
Seriously? Right now? You're doing that right now? It's like crazy high, right? Are you scared?
You're not helping. I hope I get chosen.
The bond is pure, untouched by humans. But we Saren too are a little too human. Even now, I use a human instrument to speak with you.
Well, it takes all weapons to win a war, right?
That sounds like something Mercer would say.
You'll do great. Don't fall, okay?
Priya!
The bond requires trust on both sides. I'm not sure she is ready to trust yet. Remember, the choice belongs to the IKRAN, not to you.
It's okay. I won't hurt you. No! What am I doing wrong?
She is not sure of you yet. Keep going. Maybe she will reward your efforts.
I'm starting to feel like I won't get chosen.
She is just teasing. Be strong. Aelan, take heart. The bond is a precious thing to be cherished. A life linked forever with your own. I met Zome at this very spot. She reared up, snapped at me. My stomach churned, my palms slippery with sweat. My heart pounding so hard against my ribs I thought it would burst. But her bravado was all for show. Eyes found mine and my heart slowed. My breath came steady. I knew she would choose me. I felt it.
Whoa! Easy there.
Now name her. She has made herself yours.
I think I'll call you Katir.
A new bond. It is wondrous to fly on thought alone, to touch the mind of another. Your hearts beating as one. You must secure the bond with a final act of trust.
How do I?
Call for her! Call for your IKRAN! Fly high together and secure the bond!
Yes! We did it, girl! You did it! Thank you. Thank you. Okay, let's think. Feel what to do. Can you go faster? That's it! Let's dive! You're hungry, huh? You hungry, girl? You want a treat? You do, don't you? There you go. Good girl. We should get going. Hope the Oranahe hunters agreed to help us. I bet you've seen those nasty RDA balloons, haven't you, girl? I'm not so sure we can take them out alone. Come on, let's find Ekua. Good to see you, Katir.
Your IKRAN is fierce and proud. It saw a kindred spirit in you.
Your father refused to help.
They all did. Doesn't matter what I say, they still see me as my father's daughter, not as the Sahik.
You are all he has left.
I am more than my mother's shadow. She loved this place. When I was a child, we'd fly here together, her holding me tight on her IKRAN. We'd lay down here. And tell each other stories about the stars. I felt so grown up then.
She made you feel important.
It was the stories of the Kinglor I loved most.
I wonder what stories my people had.
They stole them from you. All the Sky People have taken. My mother saw how their hearts are ruled by ignorance and greed. She stood up and was cut down, dying with Sky People metal inside her. We never spoke of the resistance after that.
Your father thinks the price of fighting them has been too great, will be too great.
If we do not fight, we will lose everything. We did not want war. But they have made us warriors. We must bring the fight to them.
Priya? There's something happening in the air here. A signal from these strange devices.
Those RDA aerial thingies? Huh.
It's disturbing the Kinglor and their food cycle in the rainforest. If we help the Kinglor, we help the Aranahe.
Hey, can you scan one? I'll try to find out what they do.
What?
Knock, knock.
Priya, what are you doing?
It's knock, knock. You know, you just say, who's there,
this
all right? Like someone's knocking on a door.
Is a
okay,
strange
knock, knock.
Form of
who's there? I know it's you, though.
No, just, okay,
am
just
I being
play
along.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Water. Now you say water who?
Water who?
Water, you doing telling jokes. Don't you have more important things to do?
I'm still here.
Anka said that joke was dumb, but it isn't, right? Come on, help me prove a point.
It's great, Priya. Definitely the best knock-knock joke I've ever heard.